Ah, it's a marathon. We'll just keep on shooting. I got this, excuse me, wonderful old Martin. Not even sure what year it is, but it is a, before the days of truss rod Martin. I guess I could look that up. Just what I want to be, an encyclopedia of useless information. But hey, I guess, whatever pays the bills. Alrighty, what did I do with that bridge pin? Oh, there it is. So, let's see. Pre-truss rod, Martin. Playing a little tight, it's threatening out, and I don't know, the owner brought it over, and I just sort of glanced at it, and I didn't really look to see that it was a pre-truss rod version. So we'll talk about those numbers. So from the magical Bible book over here, it says that the string height at the 12th fret for the bass E string should be minimum 3/32, which is 6/64, or maximum 7/64. So I raise this guy up a little bit, and right now it is sitting magically just a whisker below 6/64 or 3/32, and on the treble side it's sitting, wow, just right on the minimum height that they recommend. And the thing was, it really was not that much out of spec, because you know we like low string action and all that sort of stuff, but it was enough to make the guitar not play well. We have a Defretta buzz. That's not the kind of buzz I'm after. Changing the strings one at a time, Dave. Because it's a non-truss rod guitar. I don't want to send it into a trauma. Lager. Oh, geez. I guess I wasn't even recording. I was talking about the this stuff for the tiny little bit of shim. It's engineered veneer, so it's consistently the same thickness, which I believe is 22 thou of an inch. All right, let's get this strung up and get out of here. I don't see any light. Oh, I do see a little light popping through there. Around there. Yes. Oh, goodness. Let's have a look. yeah, so I was reading a thing I thought was pretty funny. It's just like, how do you tell if an old person is commenting on YouTube? Well, they usually think that the person who made the video is actually going to see the comment, and they've got the caps lock smashed off. Which brings me to a little topic. We'll get there in a second. I want to make you listen to this, because I can't reach the camera from here. Yeah, so commenting. Commenting on YouTube is dead. Commenting works. Say, for instance, you're sitting around a table of friends, you know, possibly 6-8 people, who knows, and you made a comment. There's a chance someone at the table might hear it, acknowledge it, and it becomes part of a conversation. But fortunately, on YouTube, I never see them. So, like, I'm guessing 1%. Not only do I don't get notified about them, but based on the number of videos I have, I can't possibly answer comments. So just comments, it's just, you might as well just throw it to the wind, boys, because nobody's hearing you. I'm going to make you listen to this again, too. Apparently, I have a minute of battery to spit this in. It's all good now. Okay, yeah, the commenting, forget it. You can send me a personal message through YouTube, but they sort of hide that. And you can always reach me on Facebook, Dave's World of Fun Stuff. And if you really want to harass the shit out of me, you can become a patron. Cheers, folks.